I was thinking, for me it's better I don't romanticize things as much anymore. I was suffering so much all the time. I still have lots of dreams, but they're not in regard to my love life. It doesn't make me sad, it's just the way it is.
Is that why you're in a relationship with somebody who's never around?
Yes, obviously, I can't deal with the day-to-day life of a relationship. Yeah, we have, you know, this exciting time together, and then he leaves, and I miss him, but at least I'm not dying inside. When someone is always around me, I'm, like, suffocating.
No, wait, you just said that you need to love and be loved.
Yeah, but when I do, it quickly makes me nauseous. It's a disaster. I mean, I'm really happy only when I'm on my own. Even being alone, it's better than sitting next to a lover and feeling lonely. It's not so easy for me to be a romantic. You start off that way, and after you've been screwed over a few times, you forget about all your delusional ideas, and you just take what comes into your life. That's not even true. I haven't been screwed over. I've just had too many blah relationships. They weren't mean. They cared for me, but there were no real connection or excitement. At least, not from my side.
God, I'm sorry. Is it really that bad? It's not, right?
You know, it's not even that. I was fine until I read your fucking book. It stirred shit up, you know? It reminded me how genuinely romantic I was, how I had so much hope in things, and now it's like, I don't believe in anything that relates to love. I don't feel things for people anymore. In a way, I put all my romanticism into that one night, and I was never able to feel all this again. Like, somehow this night took things away from me, and I expressed them to you, and you took them with you. It made me feel cold, like if love wasn't for me.
I don't believe that. I don't believe that.
You know what? Reality and love are almost contradictory for me. It's funny. Every single of my exes, then they're married. Men go out with me, we break up, and then they get married. And later they call me to thank me for teaching them what love is, and that I taught them to care and respect women.
I think I'm one of those guys.
You know, I want to kill them. Why didn't they ask me to marry them? I would have said no, but at least they could have asked. But it's my fault. I know it's my fault because I never felt it was the right man. Never. But what does it mean, the right man, the love of your life? The concept is absurd. The idea that we can only be complete with another person is evil, right?
Can I talk?
You know, I guess I've been heartbroken too many times, and then I recovered. So now, you know, from the start, I make no effort because I know it's not going to work out.
You can't live your life trying to avoid pain at the expense of
engagement. You know what? Those are words. I've got to get away from you. Stop the car. I want to get out.
Don't get out.
It's being around you, okay? No, don't touch me. You know, I want to get on a cab. Monsieur, arrêtez-vous. Non, c'est bon, au feu là.
No, don't. Keep going.